Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Welcome to campus and the World University Golf Championships in the Swiss Alps. Also in the program, cycling in Poland, on and off the road. And two karate disciplines at the University Worlds with competitors from 38 countries. The canton of Valais in Switzerland is the venue for the 15th World University Golf Championships in the world-famous resort of Crans-Montana. It brings together 22 countries, 133 players, 62 women and 71 men, with 80% of them from American universities.
I think they have an opportunity where they can get an education and play golf as well, and that doesn't happen in most of the European countries. I think they can play golf or they can just go to school, but we're the only place where they combine the two. And they know that we have good competitive programs, that people that go to university in the States have a pretty good opportunity to then go professional, you know, if they want to be on the LPGA or the PGA tour. So it just opens a lot more doors for them, I think. And it's higher competition, you know.
Aside of the U.S., who has their like NCAA and they have university game tournaments every other weekend, there's nothing outside of that like around the world, and this is great.
Outside the USA, just how much the best university golfers can achieve depends partly on the culture of their country. No problem in England, and certainly not Scotland, the birthplace of golf.
It is quite difficult, especially in spring semester, with lots of golf and studying, but our university, Stirling, is very good at allowing us time off and extensions and things for playing the golf, which helps.
For other countries less attuned to the game, it's more complicated for the students, and that includes Switzerland, the host nation of these championships. Well, obviously, there is a difference because they play all year long. Those who play in the United States don't have 4 or 5 months off during the wintertime. We suffer because of the snow. In addition, their schedules are planned with sport at the heart of them. So they have more training and, what's more, they have more regular training. To develop more ways of practicing golf is the only way to build a competitive university team. Students generally choose to study instead of playing sport at a high level. But those who choose to play golf emigrate. What they do is they go to study abroad. They'll go to, for example, American or British universities. And then it's difficult to get these students back and to reintegrate them into the university team of Switzerland. Two competitions are taking place here, the individual one and the team competition. And the level of golf is high. The University World Championships bring together the best amateur players on the planet. There's a very high standard. We can see it every day out on the course. And among the nations are some of the world's best players. That's important, especially because golf's got to become an Olympic sport. The game's also part of the Universiades.
in 2015 in Guangzhou, in Taipei in 2017, and in Brive in France in 2016, of course, we'll have the next University World Championships. In these University Golf Championships, the Spanish have something to live up to. They bagged a Grand Slam 2 years ago in Liberec, with their men and women taking 4 world titles, 2 individual and 2 team titles. Emilio Caruado leads the men's competition for quite a time before Malaysia's Gavin Green, the world number 5, takes over the leaderboard, finally giving way to the Mexican Gerardo Ruiz.
I started with birdie with an easy par 5, and then it was very constant pars and a bogey here and there. But 15 was, I made like a 4-meter putt that turned the game around.
The famous Par 72 course, designed by Severiano Ballesteros, is home to the European Masters, and Gerardo Ruiz will finish 10 shots under par.
It's just great. It's so nice to see all the people sending congratulation messages, and unbelievable.
The team total is calculated by adding together the scores of the 3 best golfers of each nation. And after 4 days of competition, the Spanish retain their title.
It's always tight. Every year, it's always close. You never know what's going to happen. But thankfully, the last 2 years, Spain came out on top. It was good.
In the women's competition, Spain also retained their team title, largely thanks to Silvia Bañón and Marta Sanz. And the Spanish look poised to keep the individual title too. But the duel between Sanz and Tiffany Chan of Hong Kong would be the highlight of these World University Championships.
And we made eagle together on 14 hole with 2 on, and then she made her massive putt first.
On the 18th, Marta Sanz leads by 1 shot, but Chan has the edge at the last, and the two will finish level.
I have to make it, because I know if I missed it, I'm going to lose for bigger chance, because we have 4 more holes ahead.
During the playoff on the 18th, Marta Sanz has a putt to win the competition, but she misses. Now she really has to sink this one. A saver, and Chan will sink hers to keep the scores level. And so they play the hole again. Marta Sanz once more. She can't believe it. She had to nail that putt. She's missed again.
I played it 3 times, played it well the 3 times. I just couldn't make the putt, and she played really well. Got to make the putt on the 3rd time, so I just congratulate her for her job, and I'm still happy with it.
So this time, Tiffany Chan has the putt for the victory.
It came to the last hole. You see, I made the birdie putt. I'm really happy and lucky that I made that putt, so yeah. I see all my friends from college because we play golf in the States, and it's really good to represent your own country and, you know, compete in the same field, because usually at college you represent your school, but then right now you really represent your own country.
And to present the trophies of these 15th World University Championships, a surprise guest, the world's number 1 golfer, Adam Scott.
It brings back a lot of memories for me. For sure, it wasn't that long ago that I was playing university sport, and you know, the team environment is very fun and something I'm not used to, but it's all part of, you know, maturing as a person and having the opportunity to travel around the world and play golf in a wonderful place like Crom, Montana, meet new people and experience different cultures is fantastic. To have the opportunity to come along and meet some young people who love the game of golf and enjoy playing it is fun for me. And if it's inspiring for them, then that is fantastic too.
And everybody already looking forward to Brive in France in 2 years' time for the 16th World University Golf Championships. He was the youngest player in history on the Asian circuit at the age of 13. Gavin Green is a giant of precociousness and talent. He's now the amateur world number 5 at 20 years of age.
My parents actually took me to the range, and then I started hitting balls, started playing tournaments, and I just never left it. I loved it ever since. So it was, I'm lucky for that.
Born in Malaysia, Gavin Green comes from a country where golf really is still in its infancy.
It's growing, you know, a lot of people are picking it up, especially younger kids. But I think it's growing at a good rate, I think. I think we just need more tournaments and just, you know, more youngsters coming up and learning. So I think it's good for the country also.
Like many young students who are talented golfers, Gavin went to the USA to progress. But is that essential?
It's not necessary, but I mean, if you want to do good in golf, I think that's the way to go, because I think the level is, that's the best level for amateurs, I think. US is just another experience. You study, you have to do everything on your own. You have to time your schedule. You have to be disciplined, more disciplined in the US, and you have to be disciplined to practice, study, you know, eat properly and learn how to cook too. So you have to do a lot of things on your own. I study business and sports management. So I'm doing two of them. I think golf and study is the same. It's similar, because if you want to do well, you got to practice. Same as school. I mean, you got to do your homework. Like golf, you got to practice and do your homework in order to do well. So you like got to practice on your swing, you got to do chip and putt and do everything for golf. And same for school, you got to, you know, study, you got to go through your all exams if you want to do well, or just same thing. I put it away, the same thing.
At 20 years of age, Gavin would love to carve out a professional career in the world of golf.
My degree is for a backup, but I'm going golf for sure. And, you know, hopefully I can, you know, make it on the tour sometime soon. So that's the goal right now.
Gavin Green has been Sportsman of the Year in Malaysia no fewer than four times, in 2006, 8, 9 and 10. Here at Crans-Montana, he finished runner-up in the World University Championship behind the Mexican Gerardo Ruiz. Could that win him a fifth Sportsman of the Year award back home? You're watching Campus, and coming next, road racing and mountain biking at the University Worlds in Poland. And we enter the world of unarmed combat with the students of karate.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student-athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Jelenia Gora in Poland, and the fifth World University Championships in cycling. The city is located in the southwestern part of the country, in the Lower Silesia region, on the border with the Czech Republic. Surrounded by four mountain ranges, Jelenia Gora is a popular place for professional cyclists. But now, it's the world's best student riders, with 22 countries at the opening ceremony, led by Poland's mountain bike heroine, the 2008 Olympic silver medalist, Maja Włoskowska.
I think people from abroad sometimes are worried to come to Poland. Poland still doesn't have such a good image as we would like to have. And always when they come here, they see that, wow, it's so beautiful. And the roads are great for road cycling.
Eight races are on the program, four for men and four for women. There are two disciplines, road races and mountain bike, in individual and mass start events.
We want to have more and more riders on the top level. Also, students are important because there is a lot of young people who sometimes even do not know that they can be great cyclists. So the events like championships for students are helping to find the good talents.
The women go first in the road competitions, a course 24.8 kilometers long with some taxing climbs. Just one lap for the individual time trial, but four laps and a total of 65 kilometers for the mass start. And here in the mass start, it's Germany's Katrin Hammes powering to victory just 24 hours after she finished as runner-up in the individual time trial.
Yeah, time trial is not my favorite, and I knew that I'm strong compared to the other competitors, and so I wanted to win today.
Katarzyna Solas-Miskiewicz finished second, Martina Klekot third. In two competitions, Poland had already won four medals, including the gold of Klekot as winner of the individual time trial. Today in Hope, we are one big team. In Poland, we take part in lots and lots of races. We've been training a lot, and normally we're opponents of each other. But today, we've come here, we've got a big, strong team, and that really is the secret of our victories and our success. And so to the men, a pack of 38 riders representing 14 countries and all seriously focused on the warm-up session, getting ready to deal with the difficult conditions expected in the race. The mass start and six laps, a total distance of 94 kilometers, including a climb of 7 kilometers called Snoskovka, the biggest test on the course. At the beginning, the Dutch are prominent, but before long, one man stamps his authority, Peter Vakoc of the Czech Republic. He's already won the individual time trial, now he triumphs in the mass start.
Everybody was watching me and waiting for me, but in my favor was playing the fact that the circuit was really hard, so when I attacked in the climb, they couldn't really follow me, so which helped me to build a small gap and then to keep it.
Petr Vakoc, two races and two victories. Still on the road, a rider and an amazing team. Bruno Dabagian is a member of Team Lebanon, which is taking part in the championships for only the second time. In Lebanon, it's a minor sport with barely 1,000 riders and an elite of 40 who have to train in difficult conditions with very little infrastructure and little support.
C'est des conditions très difficiles.
The training conditions are very, very difficult. You have to go on highways to build up stamina. And you have just one highway, 100 kilometers long. So you can make up to 200 kilometers on a round trip at the most. And for the rest, you have mountains 30 minutes away from the capital. So you always have to ride there on the main highway. And even uphill in the mountains, you're still on a main road. It's very dangerous. We've had several accidents. But as we love the sport and we want to fight for a higher standard, well, we make sacrifices by going along the highway. That's how it is. Yes, there have been several serious accidents in Lebanon. And the very presence of the Lebanese in these championships is a feat in itself. They've come here by their own means, and they want to enjoy it to the full. First of all, we're seeking to improve our technique as new riders, so we're already learning to get a very good balance. And it helps me give something to Lebanon, because we also tried to do our best for our country, you see. One of the main goals of the Lebanese riders is to multiply connections, to learn, exchange, to compare themselves to the global elite. They strike up a good relationship here with the Swiss team, all part of the university spirit. The Lebanese group are really very nice. They've come here to learn. It's their first international race, so we try to share a true experience with them, and that makes them happy. It also allows us to share our passion, so we're happy too. Over the 5 days, the Swiss will take the Lebanese under their wing. And after the road racing, Elias Abou Rachid will represent his country in mountain biking.
Well, what he asked us for is a bit of support to explain to him a little bit what this mountain bike course is. He's never ridden something like this, and the fact that I've given him a little advice here and there really has helped him a lot. For Elias, these World University Championships are a summit, and the mountain biking circuit is a real shock for him. Mountain biking's Lebanese circuits are like road circuits compared to this one. The first time I saw all these very steep downhill sections and this huge course, well, I cried. It took me a lot of time to adapt. And thanks to the Swiss team, they haven't left me alone for 1 minute. They've really taught me how to negotiate the very technical passages and the steep descents. I could never have done all this without them. Because he was a little bit afraid and had never done this kind of descent, he was very tense in his arms. I told him, for example, to relax a little bit, to use his hands as shock absorbers, and that certainly helped him a bit. In the individual race, Elias will complete the course 5 minutes behind the winner. But on this tricky and treacherous circuit, with a vertical drop of more than 60 meters, he got to the bottom, and that in itself was something to celebrate. What is really important in a championship like this is that you can gauge yourself. Coming from Lebanon, okay, I was champion in mountain biking and in time trial. Then I came here, and I couldn't do anything. I was almost ashamed to say that I was a national champion in view of the standard of this competition. Everyone was stronger than me. Everyone had more technique than me. So I said to myself, you know, you've got a long way to go. Elias Aboul-Rachid was exhausted after the mountain bike time trial, but he would complete 5 of the 6 laps in the mass start. The mass start will close these 5th World University Cycling Championships. In the Polish forest, a 4-kilometer circuit, extremely rugged, requiring strength, skill, balance, and constant risk-taking. Among 15 women at the start, the Poles leave as favorites. They know the circuit, with Katarzyna Solis-Miskowitz, the one to watch.
This is a track Maja Wojtowska, yes, our silver medalist from Peking. She's the member of the track, yes, she's riding here. And physically it was as hard as technically.
This World University Championship race is just about the same standard as the professional World Cup.
2 years ago, I asked a downhill guy, my friend, to build some part of the course, and he used all the rocks that were possible to use. So there are sometimes very difficult parts where you have to ride through the rocks, between the rocks, jump off the rock. There are also difficult downhills with a lot of roots on this course. In that conditions, there is no possibility that somebody from the accident will win the race. You have to be a good rider, strong rider, and very good technically riding rider. So for sure it will be a world-class rider.
After the women, the men's turn. For the last event of the championships, the men riding 6 loops around this course are Marek Konvar, winner of the individual, the favorite riding at home. The mass start with 21 athletes in the field. Marek ranked 6th at the last Olympic Games, and he'd lead for half the race. But that was the moment when the Swiss rider, Emilien Barben, in ambush in 3rd place, would take the lead on a turn. And Emilien would hold that lead all the way to the finish line to become the University World Mountain Bike Champion.
Well,
Yeah, I think that university is a title you can't look down at. When we study at school or at university, it's not easy to train, you know. We're somewhat disadvantaged compared to many professionals. So when you're at the start of a race with all the students who have the same status as you, who suffer like us in training, who also combine studies and sport, well, it's nice to be in a competition with people who are at the same level as you are. A wonderful spirit of competition and camaraderie at the 2014 World University Cycling Championships. Still to come on campus, karate in Montenegro. Plus, a look at the sport of archery and wrestling. Stay with us, won't you?
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade. The home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
The city of Bar in Montenegro, all set for the 9th World University Championships in karate. 300 athletes representing 38 countries making the trip to the Balkans, confirming the good health of this discipline in the university world. Karate is divided into two types of competition, kumite, or fight, in 5 weight categories for men and women, and kata, a discipline of very technical and codified movements. The kata team competition demanding very high accuracy on the part of the 3 fighters involved.
It's a very good experience and important start for us, for our team, and of course for our country.
One of the Belarus team, the winners of the women's team competition ahead of Macedonia and Mexico.
It's amazing feelings to stay at the pedestal at the first place, and we'll try to win at the different competitions, and we'll train more and more hard.
In the kumite contest, the Japanese won 2 of the 5 individual gold medals and the team competition. Other titles were won by Egypt, Iran and Slovakia. For all these student athletes, the World University Championships are a wonderful opportunity to meet some of the world's best in the sport of karate.
It's a good opportunity to fight with the best of the world. Here we can fight with the best of the hunky, and it's really good for me because it's make me better than I was.
In the men's competition, several athletes compete in both the kata and kumite events. Ahmed Shawki for Egypt will round off his last World University Championships with a medal in both categories.
It's amazing to finish my career in university with a gold and a silver medal in the World University Championship.
In these championships, the Japanese would win 5 gold medals in 12 competitions. Iran winning 3, including the title in the under 60 kilogram class, with Amir Mahdizadeh on the road to the Senior World Championships. It's a good tournament for me because in a few months' time, I'll have the World Championships in Berlin in Germany. And from my point of view, it was a good tournament with a high standard to prepare for those championships. An excellent tournament for Iran. They also won that team gold medal, defeating Macedonia. In the sport of archery, 32 countries and 206 student athletes took part in the 10th World University Championships. The Koreans winning the women's team events, all of them, Taipei and Italy, winning the individual titles. Mexico won the men's individual recurve competition and the compound team event. In the individual compound, a Ukrainian victory, while Chinese Taipei won the team recurve and Korea to the mixed competition. And finally on campus, a look at the 11th World University Wrestling Championships held in Pécs in Hungary. The men compete in freestyle and Greco-Roman, the women in freestyle only. The Greco-Roman discipline, including the heaviest category of the championships, the men's under 130-kilogram class. A victory here for the Hungarian Balint Lam, beating Turkey's Ismail Güzel in the final. With 5 wins out of 8 events, Hungary won the team competition ahead of Turkey and Poland. At home in the under 71-kilogram class, Thomas Lorenz would take the win, beating the American Patrick Smith and launching the Hungarian success to come. Just some of the action of the World University Championships, and that was Campus.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders,